Hello everyone, hope you all are doing good. I'd like to thank you all for such an overwhelming response. The response you have given me, I wasn't expecting it to be true. I just shared the photographs with just in mind just what I made for the cycling community, with just a mindset that it's nothing compulsory to spend hefty amount of bucks on accessories, but we can, if we have the instinct, we can do it ourselves also. So just I'll walk you through quickly with the stuff which I have done. I'm having a Chevrolet Beat, as you can see, and with that I have two bikes. This is a 29er Hard Rock, and the other one I'm having a road bike of Giant, which is SCR2. So as you know, like, both the bikes are of the pretty different geometry, pretty different purpose. This is a hardtail bike and that one is a proper racing road bike. So and I was facing pretty much difficulty in carrying both the bikes. I used to dismantle the front fork and I used to carry it in the rear of my car, which was damaging the inner vehicle and the plastic body and all. So what I've done here is, like, I have split the rack in two parts. The first is, this is the rear of the rack and this is the front of the rack. This is having the front fork mounting quick release system, two of them. One is for the hardtail bike and the other one, that one, is for my road bike. Accordingly, I have designed the rear mounting frames of the tire, which will secure the rear of the bike. So to walk you through, I mounted it on the roof rails. I mounted it on my car roof rails. This is aligned with the front fork. This is having the width of my tire. I took the exact dimensions, exact width of my tire, and I aligned it in the center of the front axle. So I took the dimensions, I took it, I made it a steady fit, I checked it, and then I took the dimension and marked it over here so that the center of the bike stays in geometry, in alignment with the center of the fork. This is the secondary wheel holding position, which will be carrying the front of the bike, front tire, the front wheel of the bike. These two are pretty wide. These are for the hardtail bike, the MTB one. These, on the other hand, contrary, are the narrow ones. Let me walk you through with these ones. So these are for my road bike, the Giant one I told you, which is having the wheel size of about 25C, the tire dimensions. So I had to ensure that the bike wheel width would be a perfect fit and it won't wobble around, it won't be loose, there won't be any play. This is, again, I have done the same way I did over there. I took the center of the rear wheel, the center of the bike, and the center of the front fork. I mounted it in complete alignment. If you can see like this, this is the complete center. This will be holding the bike securely and this will be in perfect alignment. So that is pretty much about the rear. I put two aluminium tubes, aluminium being lightweight. The entire assembly is mounted on aluminium tubes, which is pretty light and pretty stable and holds it very securely. This bike around weighs 13.5 kgs. The Giant weighs around 6.5 kgs, 7 kgs, I guess. About all the exotic material it's having. So the weight distribution is pretty important in this matter. These bolts, these are pretty important and they play a very vital role in securing the bike. What they do, this is a particular U-bolt. This is the U-bolt which holds the bike, which holds the roof rail from underneath, and it passes through this pipe and the washer over here secures it. I'll try to show you the rear profile if I'm afraid is not visible. But yeah, the purpose of it is that it clamps it from the underneath. Niche se pakadta hai isko, and the bolt passes over here and then you can tighten it, you can screw it. Two here U-bolts, two over that side. Another U-bolt for mounting the front axle, the front pipe, and one over there. So total 6 U-bolts. M4 is the dimension, to be very precise, and that is pretty much about it. Nothing rocket science in this. I just improvised the design. I just took an idea from YouTube and improvised it myself. So this bike I will show you as I'm taking it for a service. So I'll show you, like, how I'll be mounting it. over the top. Catch you in a jiffy. Hi again. So here we are with the bike mounted on the roof. As I told you, the front hub is mounted on this quick release system. This gives a pretty stable feel to the bike. The rear, again, it rests on these L channels, the aluminium channels, secured by a Velcro. This is for additional safety. The rear wheel, as I told you, the additional slot which this is having for carrying the rear wheel, it is again placed in the slot on these L brackets, L angles, and again secured by a Velcro. So that's pretty much about it. Nothing very complex assembly. And yeah, I would like to show you these also. These are roof mounting straps which I bought it from Decathlon. B-twin straps somewhere costed me around 600 or 700 bucks. But these are carrying straps which I don't use that very much often, because that particularly the roof front fork, it does the job pretty well. It holds it securely. So few things to remember about it, like the type of aluminium you are using. Like this is a 1-inch by 1-inch tube. It depends on your vehicle size, what sort of vehicle you are having, what is the clearance between these. This is again to be noted, the clearance between the roof rails, so that this U-bolt, it can pass from here all the way to this side, and come up from the other side, and you can screw it up. So this clearance is important. The weight of your bike is very much important, how much heavy your bike is and how long you want to carry it. So make the choice of the material yourself. This pipe is again been cut into a U section so that half rests on this, half rest onto the roof rail, and the half is giving strength to the channel. I've placed these rubber strips underneath them so that they do not damage the roof of my vehicle. These strips, as you can see, these start from here and they go all the way to the other side. They come up till here. So this is all about it. This is about the rack, the construction, the geometry, the size. I always wanted a roof rack because it gives a pretty premium feel to the vehicle. It enhances the beauty of your vehicle. It gives you a very outstanding head turner. Basically, this is a very big head turner. In whichever events I take the bike, I've got a lot of inquiries about this rack. And yeah, I'm also working on a design which can be a universal fit. Let's see, hopefully I'll be finished with that soon. And that's it for now. Catch you all later. Happy riding and safe riding. Bye bye. If you have any comments, any queries, you do PM me, do message me, do inbox me. I'd be very happy to help you all. Bye bye. Until then, see you next time.